last
She just looked like the most ordinary girl ever, right? He's fully tatted. Would never think they were a fan of mine. And they were like, oh my god, she has a tattoo of you!
Do you like the tattoo?
That's crazy, I gotta get it.
And they were like freaking, right? So she goes, shows me, and it's her entire back. It's me, like that picture of me, that pony from the Tried Kingdom.
You fucking rock, man.
I can't believe
oh my god.
No, but you wouldn't have believed it. And like, yeah, they were really sweet, and they were like really excited.
Can I get one too, please?
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, here you go. I have to flash. Thanks. Thanks, Gwen.
He takes the camera, he goes, oh my god, it's Gwen!
Oh my god, it's Gwen! Okay.
But this is like a heavy metal guy, like, you know.
Next video!
Got it,
next
got
video!
It.
Next video!
It was crazy.
Bye, Gwen. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Gwen. Thank you.
Roll me up. We said that we should start the whole video off with that. The whole documentary. Yeah, right. Oh my gosh, Cristofani!
I definitely believe that music is a gift and it's magical. And that I don't really feel like when I write a song that it's really has to do with anything to do with me. Like, it's kind of, it's there. Like, I'll look at the page and I'll be like, wow. If it's good. If it's good, I'll be like, wow. That's, you know, how did I do that? How did that happen? It is very powerful, and I've seen the power of music because I've seen it by the people that I meet.
Nice to meet you.
Sir, stay in front, relax. Front, guys.
Thank you.
That's so awesome.
All right, guys, we gotta go. Thank you.
You gotta check out this girl's tattoos, dude.
How you doing?
I got a lamb tattoo.
I got a lamb. I got no doubt.
I got Danger Zone and Too Late, and the rest of my life.
You have Danger Zone on your body?
Oh my
Danger
God.
Zone,
Gwen Stefani. There's your GS, and then there's Too Late ending. I love you. You don't understand. You don't understand. If you weren't here, I wouldn't be here.
Oh, come on.
I'm so
That's
serious.
Not true.
No.
That's not true.
No, you don't understand. I love you.
She's I love you so
much. We gotta
really
do a few
cool
pictures,
people.
Okay?
Nightmare.
Say hello.
Oh,
make sure you say hello.
Hi. How are you doing?
Oh
my god.
Everybody say hi.
These are all your little lamps. I can't believe this.
There we go, okay?
Thank you.
And everybody, right to the camera.
I gotta call my mom.
Oh, you're so sweet.
I love you. Thank you. Okay, I love you. Bye.
Don't cry.
Hello.
I ain't no halibut girl.
Perfect. Do it again.
I know. And I love when you do that, you know.
Yeah.
I know halibut girl. I ain't no halibut girl.
I don't know if I should say boring ever again after that, because that was not boring.
No.
I ain't no halibut girl. I mean, I did around the track. That's not the right part. Two times I've been around the track.
Oh my god.
Is that when you leave late, everything takes 40,000 years to get out of those things, so I'm not gonna stress out. I'll have to be so bad.
Stop in your way. Oh, sorry. Sorry.
Thank you.
All right, Matt.
Thanks, Gwen.
Hey, you rock tonight, Gwen.
Now push forward.
Hey, everybody. Cool. Thank you.
Love you. Thank you.
Give me some room.
Jump squad.
So scary out there.
Yeah.
Literally, it's like so scary. I would never, ever go through there without Curtis.
I don't blame you.
So scary out there.
It's not scary for me. That's when I'm on.
Oh my god.
That's when the show begins.
Oh my god.
perfect example of why I stay in my lane.
I mean,
you get out of your lane, you get out of your element. I have nothing to do with wardrobe. I'm security.
You know your department.
Exactly. We all have a role to play.
And what is your role?
My role is security. I'm concerned with her safety and well-being. That's it. I don't book her flights. I don't know where her luggage is going. I know where she's at, and she is safe. Because I'm there.
There's your picture, mate.
Gwen!
They get so excited.
They really do. Man, honestly, look at
it. I feel like Cinderella right now.
It makes me feel worthy. It makes me feel like I'm contributing. It makes me feel like I'm using some kind of a gift that was given to me that I have no real control over, but if I am open to it, then sometimes it works and it's like magic, and I just feel like it's my responsibility to try to keep pushing that button over and over again.
Okay, take it down. Put
that
in charge.
Hey, can you give me some more sunglasses
for
somebody?
I just feel like I need a new couple looks. I got these Burberry ones, but... Yeah, they're cute. Red and red.
That's cute. Michelle,
Thanks for coming
over. Thank you.
I feel so spoiled.
You are.
I know.
That's a good thing.
I'm spoiled.
There's nothing wrong with that. So dig in.
Sometimes I'm not feeling some of the weird shapes, but... Rad.
Wow, they're beautiful.
Those are amazing. Do I choose and then you send them? Is that what we're doing?
I'll leave them here for you today. I brought everything.
Wow.
You're done deal.
I'm a lucky biatch. Wow, mine? It's weird how my glasses are in your thing.
Okay. Similar, but a little different.
So you just came over to give me some glasses?
Oh yeah, these I like.
Yes.
Can you believe my life? How many can I have?
My dad's a really good friend. I feel like she was doing something with
other people. These are like Barbra Streisand.
I
feel very verklempt right now.
Yeah, she's our...
I said to Pete, can you please, you know me, just like passing, get someone to bring me some glasses. Because he takes all these people out to coffee and gets friendly with them. So then he just called her the next thing, and she goes, wait 1 second, the girl's here with the glasses.
Oh my God.
These are hot, right?
Those are hot. Mm-hmm. Sorry. They're great.
Dude.
Oh, that was
rad.
I'm not gonna lie. Free shit is the best.
I like theater and I like drama and I like girly stuff and I like costumes and I like things that are not rock and not, you know, in that world that you're not, like, it's not cool, like, in the rock world to have costume changes, you know what I mean? So I just want to, like, that's why I want to do this tour, because I always dreamed about, like, being in a musical or, like, doing theater or something like that, because I think it's just something I have a love for. I don't know, I can't explain why. So this is my chance right now to do it. So I've been selfish and said, okay, I'm gonna go on the tour.
If we do all three shows, we can focus one of them on a band, which would be this perfect, because it's the right stage for it. It's a flat thing and you get the right angles.
So that one we can focus on the band part of it. We do the Teen Choice Awards, we focus all on dancing. We do all of those drill team. We don't even need to have a band. We have a small drum line. We have all the drill team girls. We bring in all the drill team. We do all dancing, crazy girl outfits. We do MTV Awards and we focus on cheerleaders and we bring in all the flippers and all the cheerleaders. It's like there's three different ways you can do the song creatively.
I think with the way that we have it sorted right now and the plan we have, it will be incredible.
Wow, the show's gonna cost $700,000 to $1 million.
Hey, so how much of your life do you spend at this place? Would you say?
What, rehearsal?
Well, at this SIR, isn't this where you always?
I've been here a lot of times.
How many years have you been coming?
No doubts. How many years have I been coming here?
Yeah.
Probably 10 years. Probably. So since after the Tragic Kingdom.
Hi, Donnie.
All right, how are you?
Fire
up.
Hi guys.
Hi.
Did you do good?
Yeah.
You know,
Did you know about the MTV Japan nomination?
No.
You're nominated.
My mom for what?
In Japan.
My mom called me. You know, I said it like, my mom called me. I love how she talks.
Yeah, in Japan. You know, really? Japanese MTV Awards? I mean, yeah.
What is it? MTV Japanese Awards. Yeah. I go, what is it? MTV Japanese Awards. Yeah. So we're nominated for what? Best band in the whole entire world? Probably.
My mom forgot.
My mom forgot.
Check, check it. Yeah, one, tick, tick, tick.
Rehearsed, kind of half-assed because I'm really tired. But I think I got it. It's like, I'll just ad-lib. What are you going to do? It's the best way.
Are you really going to go on tour?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just looking into it.
It would be fun to go on tour and, like, create a whole, like, show. Like, have really, like, production.
Totally.
It affects so many people if I go on tour. It affects my husband, which he'll be on tour anyway, so hello, I'm going. It affects my children, who are being delayed, poor things. It affects, my band, who, you know, are not sitting around, but they're waiting to go make another record, obviously. And then it also affects all the other people that I've committed to, like my fashion people and my, you know, all the other like projects that I'm working on, because it means that I have to really, like, those 2 months, I can't give attention to everybody that I'm committed to. So it's going to be pretty stressful. Plus it's like so physical. Like we talked about working out and all that stuff. I mean, that the pressure of having to be totally fit and clean and, you know, keeping my voice in check, and then, it's going to be a lot of pressure, because usually I have the band to make up for some of the things that I can't do, and they're not. I'm going to do everything, so.
Can you talk while you cook?
What do you want to know?
I want to know about these phoners. I don't even know what they are.
I have to call all of the radio stations, because my show's going on sale. The shows are all going on sale. So I have to call those radio stations, and then they do interviews.
It's one thing to do one or two, they're really fun, but after you have to do 2.5 hours of them, they're each like 10 minutes long, it's really a lot, and it's tedious, and it sucks. But I'm not complaining, am I?
I know that everyone's going to think that I cook, but I don't.
Shows,
nothing against you guys, but everyone's all, "Bah! Good morning! I'm going to the party!" And then they're like super hyper and trying to make jokes the whole time.
What? What's weird? What's happening?
Todd.
Todd, where?
He's not here, man.
Oh, the fly on the wall. Honey, your flies are undone. Flying low. Zip it out.
I knew that when Pharrell and I wrote the song and we looked at each other like, oh my God, this song is ridiculous, and we were really excited about it, but you never know what's going to happen, you know?
I felt very honored to be retired on TRL. Thank you very much.
All right, for sure. Now, I heard you were just in Italy shooting your next video for the song Cool. So what can you tell us about that one?
Yeah, that was, it was incredible. We flew to Italy, Lake Como, and I get to play like a young Italian girl that hooks up with my ex-boyfriend. I don't really hook up with them. I meet up with them. It's a beautiful video. I'm really proud of it. I'm going to go and show Interscope, all the people at Interscope tomorrow, so I'm really excited about it. Thank you.
Song in the whole United States right now. In the whole United States, okay? Me and you hanging out, writing a stupid banana song. That is the stupidest song ever, and it's the biggest song ever. So, still number one. Did anyone notice? Fourth week in a row, number one song in the country. Thank you. And number seven on the chart. Kind of a big deal.
Huge.
That's 4 weeks. It's a month. I could have got my period again.
It's a full cycle.
BET's premiering Holla Back. They're gonna start playing that video. They never played it.
Oh really?
No, they don't play White Girls. They only played Tina Marie was the last one.
You're gonna break the record of spins in like 6 weeks or something crazy.
Wow.
First song to top both of these charts in Billboard at the same time.
Isn't that amazing?
That's crazy.
It's unbelievable.
Ever?
Well, this, wow. This chart's fairly
Honey,
new.
Honey, come look. I'm getting an award. Honey, first time ever to have both of these charts at the same time.
Number one on both.
That is so exciting. I never thought I'd be on a Billboard ever, let alone on two of them.
Number one.
This is Gunner's house. Hey Gunner.
Todd, I told Gunner about our genes that we have.
Which gene? Oh, our
heritage.
Our lack of not being able to eat without dying.
Guaranteed, if I'm in a bad mood, somehow it helps me get out of my bad mood if I work out. And it just makes me feel stronger, it makes me feel more alive, it makes me feel healthier, it makes me feel more confident, it makes me look better and fit into the clothes that I like to wear, and I have to do it even though I don't want to. But at the same time, I do. Once you get me there, it's all about getting me there. Once I get there, I really actually enjoy it, because I think a bit of a manly tomboy side to me that when I work out, it brings that out of me, and I like that.
I need this. My yin and my yang, and the male and the female, the strong and the weak. And the workout is the strong part, and the eating the pizza is the weak part.
Tell me about the Harajuku clothing line. It's really popular. I mean, tell me about
it. Well, I mean, is it really popular? It hasn't come out yet. It's about ready to
But people are talking about it, we've gotten calls about it, Z100.
Really, really.
We've given stuff away, so tell me about
it. It's a project I've been working on for about a year. Instead of doing a merch line, like your regular Gwen Stefani shirt, you know, it's a lot more creative. It's all based on Love Angel Music Baby, the characters. Basically, it's everything from, like, scented banana erasers and pens and stationery and...
So you're involved with everything involving the clothes?
I design the entire thing.
We have all of the sketches to date up on the board. We have to edit this down because there's not even jeans, there's not sweatshirts, there's not t-shirts, that's not even on the board yet, too. So it's like, we can't have that many clothes. So we're going to edit as much as we can today.
And now, is this for the line or is this for a runway show?
This is for both, you know. It's like, I'm taking both into consideration, so, yeah.
So we will see some of this on the runway, possibly.
Most of it, yeah.
Before we even get into anything, I'd like to make a speech.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I know everyone's working very hard,
yes.
And everyone's passion is on fire. Got an email from Ken Erman this morning saying that we are 1 month behind officially. So, I don't know how we could possibly be, but that's what the note was, saying these are the things that need to happen. So let's just know that today we can't get off track.
Yeah.
We need to just...
So I tell you what the main thing is here.
Okay.
Is first, the main thing is to edit shapes. Like, what do we like, what don't we like anymore, what works and what doesn't work. Then we take it off.
I'm gonna throw up over the bow jacket.
The bow jacket is nuts.
Throwing up right now. Oh my god, that is so beautiful. Look at that.
It's amazing.
I love you so much. I can't believe it. I feel like it's mostly something I do for fun. It doesn't seem like, there's not pressure with it. There's no, it's not for anyone else but me. I'm not trying to prove anything to anyone with it. It's not an emotional drain. It's very kind of greedy. It's very like, you know, I know what I want. It's very like that. It's very selfish, the whole designing thing. And it's something that I'm really familiar with. I've done it my entire life. So, you know, I'm the girl that, like, I'm the daydreamer that just sat in class and just designed stuff. And then as soon as it was out, I was in the car to the fabric store by myself, hanging out, looking through thousands of, you know, bolts of fabric, and it's just something I've done forever. So to be able to do it on this level, it just makes me feel, it's just so like a luxury, you know? And I would be really, really sad if they took it away and said, you don't get to do that anymore.
Hi, girl. What you doing?
Wait till you see what we shot. It's so good. How's your meeting go? That was the longest meeting ever. You okay? You want to shake it off?
Hello. So, you mean, like, how will we...
You want to go to the back?
So, yeah, we'll show her the back ones. Do you want to show her some of the ones of Love and the little things?
You guys should be wearing glam tennis shoes.
They brought theirs, and we've been working them in.
Shit.
These have turned out really cute. The ones in the little panties have turned out really cute.
Hello.
No cellulite, right?
Beautiful. Great. Okay, thank you.
It really came together.
It really is going to be great. I mean, obviously there's little things to fix, but that's always like that. I mean,
exactly.
I'm really happy. Yeah. Just look at that outfit.
Cool. Very good.
Sexy poses of you guys, like where like you're like on the ground, like, you know.
Okay.
That. It's gonna be for actually to be printed on a shirt, and then we'll see her as she loves it. It's for the guy shows.
Just a little bit. Oh, that's sexy. That's good.
Oh yeah, this one's really good.
Oh, that's perfect.
I mean, since Love Angel, you know what to do.
Wrong, but it's perfect how they're doing it. Perfect. And the girls look incredible, and the clothes look incredible. And
when I get a bad review for my fashion, because I will, it's not going to hurt me at all. I'm not doing it for them. I'm doing it for me. I'm the one that wears the clothes. I'm the one that thinks they're cute. It's like it's all taste, you know. So obviously, some people aren't going to like it, you know. And I've been criticized all the time for things that I've worn my entire life, and it never stops me.
Does he want to go right into the meeting?
I've never been to these meetings before.
It's really, there's a lot of people in there.
Like, how many people?
Like 30.
Hey. Hi.
Oh. Oh my God, hi. This is so weird. I always wanted to come to one of these. And I really wanted to come play you guys a cool video. Because
wow.
I'm really proud of it. And I want to say thank you so much for everybody for working on this record. I'm like, I feel like I'm on drugs. I'm so excited to be here.
Such the face of Interscope, you know? I mean, she's been with us from the very beginning. I mean, her career has mirrored our success. And look, she's at the height of her game right now, you know? And the company's, what, 14 years old?
I'm crying. You're making me cry.
I'm a dinosaur here.
And I'll say it again. When you guys have grandchildren, they look back on Interscope and where you guys were, they're going to ask you what she was like. I'm telling you, she's here right now, but that's exactly what's going to happen. So get as many pictures with her as possible. I'm telling you, I know, because 30 years ago, people asked me about people that I knew then, and thank God I have some nice photos. We love you, Glenn.
Thank you.
You know
Thank you so much for everybody that just put so much time into it, and this is basically mine and Jimmy's solo record together. And I didn't even dream that I would do this record, so, and be able to work with so many incredible people and be able to cross over, and it's outrageous, really. So.
You have crossed over. You have crossed over.
Oh, that. Is that what he's talking about?
I cannot believe that I crossed over to Black Radio.
It happened on its own. It just happened. Now they're going to push it, but that's so weird. Oh my God, my underarms are like water pits from being in there. And it smells really good.
Oh, I'm so excited about everything.
Aren't you?
A lot of the stuff that's come up in the last year or 2 years in my life has been stuff where I just like talk shit and say, oh, I'm going to do this thing. And next thing I know, I'm actually doing it. And it's really overwhelming. Something to like say that I'm going to be going on this tour. I've never toured without the band before. Those guys, you know, we all play roles, and without them, I just don't know if I can pull the whole thing together. I mean, it's gonna be a kind of show that I've never done before. I don't know how to do. But I think what happens is it's like little baby steps, and as I just keep like coming up with more and more ideas, and you go into rehearsal and you just start doing one song at a time, one verse at a time. You know, next thing you know, you get the costumes together. I think it will just all come together.
Let's
can we just acknowledge the fact that I have a digital camera with my picture on it?
That is so cute, the picture.
I was really blown away by the website. Okay, but your stuff, your...
Wait, I haven't seen this yet. I have to look at it. Look at the little bag it comes in.
Oh, that's so cute.
Where's the charm? Mine doesn't have a charm in it, okay? That's all I want to say.
Did that one real long time ago. Found it. And I think I was gonna have
first Harajuku Lovers release. It's the camera. It's limited edition. It's only 3,000 that they made, so it's probably sold out already. Just kidding. Now it makes sense. Everyone's like, why are you getting camera? Like trying to make me like I'm a sellout. Well, you know what? Wait till you see what the whole thing is and then judge it.
Oh my god. Bitch, that is some fly ass shit.
It says the Harajuku song on it.
Oh, okay, miss. Yes,
you can. You have everything. Wow.
I bought mine.
I got mine today.
But they gave it.
Now I have two of them.
Did you win it?
Or they gave them out to us out in the crowd out there. So.
Wow, congratulations.
Thanks.
How did you get picked to get that one?
We just yelled a lot.
I just yelled.
They only gave three away.
Yeah.
You're very lucky.
I also am the one who like asked her a question and stuff like that. Yeah. So, today's a very emotional day.
I can't believe this. Yeah. I know. Well, if Glenn ever sees this, do you want to say anything to her?
Oh, man. Oh, man, that's hard. I've always thought about that. I don't think she could ever say anything different than anyone's ever said before.
Oh, just that she's awesome. You're my idol.
Look, I have her. Look, right there.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. It's kind of weird, but I just love her so much. So.
That's very sweet. Okay, well, say bye, Glenn.
Thank you. Bye, Glenn. We love you.
They'll ask you about the tour with the Black Eyed Peas. They'll ask you about the clothing line. They'll ask you about sort of their artists that you've been working with lately. Yo, we're gonna pull in just right now. Yep.
I'm not taking this lightly at all. I'm really excited. I'm really honored. I can't believe it. It's really crazy. It was so funny because when I was making the video, about to make the video, instantly when we wrote the song, me and Pharrell, I was like, I already knew what the video was. You know? It was so obvious. And Pharrell caused me to panic last minute going, don't try to make it black. You know, like really like worried that I was like going to try to be like
right.
Some hip-hop
meaning
girl.
Be you. Just be you.
Yeah,
right.
Just be you. And right. I was like, don't worry, dude, I got it. It's going right. to be fine. Don't worry, you know. But next week I'm going back out with them. I'm going to Miami to work, write some more songs. Hey, guys, like all, like, I'm going to throw up right now just thinking about it. It's so scary, you know? Because you never know if it's going to be able to write songs.
The struggle is weird. It's almost like having your period. It's like you think, am I really, why do I feel cranky right now? Oh, I'm gonna get my period. And it happens over and over again every single month. And you always say, why do I feel, it's the same thing with music. Oh, I can't think of this so hard. I'm so worried I'm not gonna be able to write. And then all of a sudden a song comes and you go, it always is like that. It always is really, really hard. And then next thing you know, a song will come out. And usually, even if maybe other people don't respond to the song, it's almost like having children where you always pretty much love the song that you write. There's a very rare chance that you might not like the song.
Given there's a very rare chance you might like the child as well.
Exactly.
Do you help me get my bag?
Neil, are you looking at this?
Look at him.
It's funny, huh? Look at
me. That makes a good documentary though, doesn't it?
How many guys were there?
Good rock.
All day.
I was just listening to the song again. It's really good. Let's go listen to it in there. Do you have any more CD plays? Oh, right here. I just need to listen to it over and over and over again. I played a video for Interscope today, and they were like, wow, it's so good, da, da, da. And then afterward I'm all, yeah, the girl in it's Tony's real girlfriend here, and there was all. Like, everyone was like, gasping. And then, now, have you looked at the website?
No. I looked at it last night and I was upset.
No, because everybody was really sweet. Like, I
and everyone's looking up Daniel Gonzalez posting pictures of him. Oh my god, Erin's in it. Oh my god, she's so fake. Oh my god, Erin. I love Erin. Oh my god, I love Erin.
It's really high for me.
It's fine. It's fine.
Okay. Play that back. Look at, no wonder you broke up with me.
I know.
That is gross.
1989, someone sold these photos to Wire Image. Neil, do you see this one?
Hey.
Oh, this one's great. These ones?
Oh, no.
Where I was way too buff.
Look at your glasses. What is Adrian doing?
That one's amazing.
Who are you with there?
Steven Seagal.
Of course.
Come on, dude.
That's his tuxedo?
Yeah.
All
right,
what's up?
Thanks for coming.
Oh, yeah. What's happening, man?
I knew you when you were only that. Right. You were only that.
Yeah, man. Good. All right, we're here.
That's my brother, Neil.
Neil, how you doing?
All right. And that's Gordon's brother, Todd. So,
yeah. What's happening, man? Okay.
Do you want to hear the track a little bit?
Oh, and look at Mr. Jimmy Iovine's just got here as well. Mm-hmm. Hi.
Hey, Jimmy.
That's Angelo. He's gonna play saxophone.
Oh, how you doing?
Hi.
Somewhere in there, and I can move them around, we're good.
You know that you're just gonna take everything and then compile it later, right?
Yeah. Awesome. Let's just, I'm gonna play that other part real quick so we make sure we get that as well. Dude, can you set the loop so it's a little bit more.
Do you ever make faces like that?
So you want to do something like upbeats?
No, I just reminded. This is like a. I like this. It was a duet. You know what I mean?
Okay, right.
They trade off. Last Saturday night. And I go. Na 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 na
cool down. Okay.
Cool down, cool down, cool places tonight. And this is totally what we're doing for spring, this 1930s. Awesome, thanks. Whoa, I love that. I'm gonna have to add, I mean, we already have too much in the collection, but that is rad. This one, this coat, with the fur on top and then the coat underneath, I'm gonna use that for fall. I'm gonna do it, because I'm doing this velvet, this amazing velvet, long-haired velvet. Wow, this is so good. There's so much good stuff in this.
back. Dip back sailor top.
I think it's more about taste when it comes to design, because also it has to have whoever I work with in designing needs to understand me and who I am and kind of get who I am and know the things that inspire me and what I draw from creatively, and then that way we can work together. So there's been I haven't really worked with tons of people when I'm designing, but the people that I do work with seem to really like go, oh, I know what you would like, and they really understand where my inspirations come from. So it's not quite as emotionally draining as songwriting is. Designing is clearly from the same place, but it's just, it's a lot more greedy. It's just kind of like, you know, oh, what can I, the ideas are endless. I'll never run out of ideas. So it's just, you know, there's no way for me to run out of an idea for designing. Whereas with songwriting, it's very kind of all on your emotions and what you're feeling and how your mood is, and it's kind of a lot more draining that way.
I'm so tired. Oh my god.
Oh my god, I'm so tired.
I'm tired. I hope I get some energy soon. What?
Too.
You're not gonna eat anything? Todd, what are you in the mood for?
You tell him, guy.
Let's
say goodnight.
You're always yawning.
Right, I'm tired. I'm tired and I'm hungry. Hello?
Hello.
So what situation?
Two shoe colors.
Two out of all of them? Obviously, you have to choose number 3, because that's my favorite one, the brown with the green and yellow. Yeah, I opened the map.
So that's kind of how you're able to navigate quickly through the site?
Okay, well, I think that actually, this to me, this is looking, and obviously it's very simplistic and needs to keep going. And
yeah.
I think that, you know, like, it's getting there though. It's going somewhere. Yeah, I hate all of this 80s kind of artwork is not happening for me at all. I don't have everything in my head exactly how I want it. Do you know what I mean? I know when I see something I don't like and when I like something. Yeah, they're not good at all. I hate them. You need to really oversee that, Jolie. I think you're gonna actually need to go sit with him and do it with him.
Okay.
I just like convince everyone. This is a good idea, and I have 2 girls flying to Tokyo to do research. People don't realize how expensive it costs to go and create the ideas. It's the same thing with my with the Harajuku Lovers line. You know, I wanted to do this. I wanted to do something for the fans. You know, that was a little more creative, and I did all these designs. I've been working on it for a year, and at the end of the day, my ideas are too expensive, and it costs too much to make the stuff. So the stuff starts being like, you know, they can only sell it for how much it costs to make. So now I'm being restricted, so I have to cut the whole line down after all that work.
Okay, cool.
Hello? This is like
the look at Curtis's handling right now. I love that.
Well, you know what, Curtis? Look carefully. I'm scared in this place. Make sure no burglars are in here. This is like the life of the rich and famous, dude. Check it out. This hotel room's crazy. Did you see the bedroom? It's in the other quarters over here.
We're good, boo.
Any guys in there?
Nope.
Nobody's gonna spend the night with me?
Nope, you're on your own. Wow.
Rad, huh?
Yeah.
Keep going, go sit to the bathroom.
Woo! Wee! Okay, say goodnight.
Okay. Goodnight.
Sweet cheeks.
I'm gonna sleep in my clothes tonight, not. It worked. My tanner. No, but I wasn't in the sun.
I know, but you look like.
I look like I've been tanning.
Which one did you use?
I did.
It's good because it protects you also when you are in the sun.
This is what girls
girls want to see.
I know, but they don't get to know.
Oh.
They don't get to know. They think that I have the natural J-Lo glow.
I was getting your tan on, and I'm like,
I'm putting on the J-Lo thing to
the
this.
J-Lo glow?
Then I'm like, no one's going to see this anyway. No one's going to want, I'm like, they don't get to know.
Yeah, don't show them. Don't show them all the secrets and tricks.
No.
They don't need all that. So you about to go on?
I'm going
to
do it, yeah. I'm excited. We've only done two shows live, so we've done the TV shows, like one song.
Yeah,
five, so I'm like,
you're not going on tour this
long. You know what?
No.
Okay. I'm thinking about it.
I'm sorry to interrupt you that 8 minutes. We could do two things at once, though. Do it. Do it. I know me. I'm like, leave me alone.
Oh my god, I'm so jealous.
No, I think we're okay.
She almost is perfect looking. I mean, she is. I hate her. I hate you.
You know, I think that I'm just like everybody else, and I definitely struggle with my body image, but at the same time, it's like I have days when I struggle with it, and other days where I'm like, whatever, you know, and I put everything I can into everything I do. So working out, like we were talking about, you know, it's just as important to me as songwriting in a way. That might sound dumb, but it helps me. Like again, it's the balance. If I don't do that, then mentally I don't feel good. So, and I told my dad, I didn't work out today and I feel shitty. No, I feel good because I worked out yesterday. I feel strong.
This part, this is the chunk that I'm trying to get rid of. Come here and take a picture of this time. Get in here and show you what I got. See it?
I can get it, but it looks ripped to me, dog.
It's like a Pillsbury dough, but
it's getting better. You should have seen when I got here.
So those are the kind of the two choices. You feel like doing a march or you feel like doing a reveal?
I don't know what I'm wearing yet. That's my problem. But probably a march would be cool.
Yeah, let's do the march. We'll do it from up here.
Who's the big star? Oscar.
That was the best performance. Somebody pissed in the pool.
Oh my god.
So what happened?
Gwen, your new fan.
Somebody's at the
I got the new Pip and Ho stuff. Beverly Hill Pip and Ho. It's pretty sweet.
Donnie just got out of the pool. Hey, were you at the spring break pool?
Yeah, I had to go to the bathroom, so I went to the pool. It's totally cool. It's totally cool.
What does your hat say?
It says, got hoes, what's up?
That is perfect.
Yeah.
That's gorgeous.
Life isn't about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. Oh, thanks so much for the incredible experience. Had an intense ride for us. Your positivity and energy is explosive and has fueled us to be better musicians. Hopefully, we can rock with you in the future. Your hollow back drum line. Today, what do I have? I'm gonna do some sketches because I got the shoe meeting and I had some ideas.
Gwen, that is fantastic.
I'm titched. So you got a wallaby front. You know, it could be leather, suede, canvas, printed with chains, buckle. You know, wood plank. How do you say that? Wood layer heel, like with planks. It could be striped.
That's gonna be sick.
Cute, right? This is gonna be for the Spring 06 fashion show, hopefully. And this is with my Royal Elastics, the tennis shoes, but they can do more than just tennis shoes. So I'm trying to push the button a little bit. I was thinking I could put like a tennis shoe bottom on the bottom of this.
Oh wait, can I use those? Those are perfect. Can I use your shoes? Do they smell? Oh, pew!
Do you know what I mean? Wouldn't that be cute? Like we could turn, cause I am doing like a slip on.
Hey dude. I'm good. What do you got stuff to show me?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm in here. A wallaby claw.
Oh wow.
And then I don't know, this is where you guys come in, but I was thinking to kind of, to add in the tennis shoe thing, add some kind of a rubber sole.
This is what we're working off right now, these colors.
Okay, so this is gonna be
these
are super cute. So this is all stitched all around.
Oh wow, so it's just like a shoe on the inside. Yeah. Yeah. That's so creative. Wow, we all are geniuses. Oh my god, I can't believe I have a spat tennis shoe. But I thought these were two cute ideas, and we could do things like where it's either, you know. Yeah, I just did these this morning. I just doing like.
So these are what you saw in Italy.
Okay, so we went through these though, dude. I'm not gonna lie to you. Me and you sat and went through these.
We almost did in London, right? We did some.
But do we have to go through them again?
No, because you kept all those pieces of paper because we didn't.
Go ahead. I already did all these with you, and I kept the ones that I didn't do. Which are right.
Well, then it's this.
Here. I mean, I'll go through them again, but these are the ones that I didn't do, and right. I have them all right here.
So this is the new canvas, which you saw the other day.
Like I said, when I approved these today, they're still going to be able to make changes.
Yes, absolutely.
What happened to the? I thought these ones were supposed to twirl around your head. They were supposed to go.
Twist up the side.
Wow, these are beautiful.
Some of our teams get rid of that.
Then this is the new leather, the gold.
Is that the same? That's different, dude. It's way shinier. It's way like brighter, I think. I love the white back here.
Yeah.
So cool. It does. Very.
You know what I was thinking? Chola
girl. Look at me.
Real gold.
We love real gold.
So the other thing is, now that you've seen all these, we're going to go make some samples and start selling them to try and deliver them for November pre-holiday.
Oh my god.
Those are the Italias, I think. Adidas Italia.
Wow. That's stupid. That's so beautiful. You're beautiful.
Wow.
Hold it, Glenn.
That
is ridiculous.
That's stupid. That is stupid with two or three O's.
All right, here you go.
Oh my god. Sweet. He walked. Oh my god.
Do you have volume?
Look. Oh my god, yeah, Andrew, yeah, yeah. Come look at this shit.
Love?
He walked.
Oh my god. Wait.
Oh, shut up, dude. That's pretty.
god. Holy shit.
Oh my god.
That's rad.
So now all this is a holder page.
Dude, so. Give me the that's if I would open this, you think I would have not written back?
Oh,
you were like, you're like, she doesn't care.
Like,
okay, this is my nephew. Let's just not freak out. And this is Nemo.
Hey, Nemo.
We're making shoes in here.
Yeah, it's a really great creative outlet that has no pressure to it. Now, saying that, I'm doing the fashion show coming up, and that is a little bit different because it's almost like, up until this point, I haven't really like said, this is my thing, check it out. But with the show, it's gonna be a little bit more like in that fashion world, which obviously I don't fit in and don't know too much about. It's kind of like saying, raising my hand and saying, look, this is, I'm trying to be in your little like clique, which I'll never fit in. I mean, I'm not from that world. I have no ideas about it, but it's gonna do my thing.
Gwen is going to rock the house, and we're going to do Hollaback Girl and Rich Girl with Eve, and the Harajuku girls are going to do a little number for you.
The Harajuku girls interviews for the website.
Right now we are at some studio in New York. We are filming the Harajuku girls. They're doing their interviews for the website. It's a day off, but obviously it's not a day off. But yeah, it's been crazy. I had so much to catch up on email-wise, and I just got it done. So I'm like excited about that.
Hi. Hey. Do me a favor. Will you sign something for my kids?
Yeah. We're doing this whole Harajuku lovers brand, which is basically, it's all inspired by these four girls who I created in my head. So they're like Love, Age, and Music Baby, and this is their chance for people to get to know who they are, because at first the whole idea was they were my fantasy, right? So they weren't even real, and I just dreamed them up. So we would come out and they would be like dolls. Over the course of a few months, we've kind of like introduce them as they are really, they've become real now, like the fantasy come true, and like they're real girls, you know. And so what we want to do is like, I want to interview them, but I want it to be sort of surreal. So I want you to really be who you are, but I also want you to make stuff up.
My face is weird.
Okay, let's see, let me fix her hair then. So how can I make this come forward? You have to take this whole thing out? I think it's sexy when it comes forward over your eye a little bit, like that. They're like little,
so it's a little blown out,
okay.
Like, you know.
Yeah.
So it's just a little bit hot.
It's fun to look ultra glamorous, not real. They're dolls, you know what I mean?
A little overexposed.
Yeah.
Okay.
A little overexposed. Now I'm directing.
No, yesterday.
So happy.
No, I'm not. I want a day off. I'm like, hi, how many jobs can you have?
I just be really animated and over the top because we want you to be like a character.
Okay. 1時間以内に走らんといけないから、こうやってから一生懸命走ってて、パッて後ろ見たら、絶対負けないぞと思って。
Oh, one more thing you could put in there. I'm late. I'm late. Tick tock, tick tock. You know, you're the white rabbit.
I'm just a girl. Rad.
I mean, I didn't understand, but I understood.
Right here?
A little more.
Right here?
You're out. Okay. Now, this side, Jason, for me, keep going.
Harajuku girls. Take one.
Yeah, that's as far as you want to come.
All right, so what do you
can you give us a...
There's no counting. Huh?
I know. Can you go like 5, 6, 7, play?
All right, good, we're done. Thank you, you guys.
Thank you.
Good luck, have good luck, everybody. Have a great time.
Check the gate.
It crosses my mind sometimes that I might be diluting myself by trying too many different things, but I won't ever do anything and let it come out unless I think it's good, so if I put, let's say for instance I try to do the fashion show and it's like not coming together, then I'll just cancel it. Or let's say if the tour's not coming together and it's already come on sale, I have 11 shows going on sale this weekend. Pressure.
Crossover, Black Radio, like this whole thing, and Pharrell calling. I guess they're starting to play Hollaback on some of these black stations, so it's like a really huge, big deal.
Every club that I go to, be it hip hop, commercial, underground, or whatever, they banging that.
It's crazy. It's so awesome because it just shows like the collaboration of, you know, the world's coming together.
I'm hearing remixes.
Really? Yeah. I want to hear remixes. That's like my dream. That's the whole reason why I did this record.
Hey, Tony, do the remix.
Wait.
Bananas.
Trying to. Hello, guys. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The audience has got to be so burnt out by now, dude. They're like so over it.
I think they're kind of waiting for it.
This
not really cut you off.
Woo!
That was fun.
Really good. Really good high energy. Well, good thing is we have enough time to get them fixed. Before.
My shoes got hurt! Woo! My shoes got hurt!
Oh, no, but
we have enough time
somebody
to get
a band-aid!
But the sacrifice was worth it, because that show was stupid.
Oh, thanks. It
was stupid. That was so good.
I sang the worst I've ever sang, but I don't care, because what am I supposed to do?
So you're in a stadium.
I'm in a stadium with the longest, like, wings with, like, high heels on, and I couldn't.
Great.
I did my best.
Did you guys have fun?
Yeah!
How'd you like it, Gosh?
Oh, I liked it way better.
I liked it, too.
She was talking about telling me you did.
Okay. I did a horrible.
What happened? You made a mistake.
I was trying to break, like, woo!
Yeah?
And I wanted to do, like, this, but I thought, I can't do it. Like, I can't.
Oh!
But I wanted to do it, and I said, and I hold it for 5 seconds like this.
That's rad. Okay, so I was like this, and I'm dancing, da-da-da-da-da. Belt totally comes off, and my pack's in my belt, so I'm like, okay, I'll just hold on to it for the rest of the song.
Oh.
And then I'm walking, and my heel goes down, you know, the circle.
Yes.
And I'm all...
What happened?
What a beautiful child. Beautiful child.
We didn't see you.
Amazing time. I love the clothes, Gwen.
Love the clothes.
So cute. And I love your songs, too.
We couldn't get that stuff together in time and have it be cost efficient to sell it because the pieces are high end. We'd have to sell it for $200. But what he's saying is if we wanted to just hustle and have something out there because everybody has something out there, we could on Monday design a shirt, like a typical giant shirt from IKEA, and get it done in time for the shows next weekend.
Okay.
If we can get a decent design and you're into it, do you want me to present that to you?
Yeah.
Like basic t-shirt kind of.
I'm going to go wash the room together. I'll be back in a minute. Yeah, Lisa.
Say, what you did today...
I went over to the morning with my parents to have breakfast. Then I went over to see my husband do the tennis tournament. Then I went over to get my makeup and my hair done. Then I went over to Anaheim Stadium. I kicked ass. I sang shit. I sang shit, but I kicked.
This is the first edit, like, they put too much animation.
You got it.
Wow, that's
gonna be
great, huh?
Hey, what's up? I'm Baby from Harajuku Girls.
Funny, right?
I love those.
Good.
Tell me, is it a before breakfast or after breakfast song?
I say we do it now.
I say
we
do.
Oh, wow. That's
fantastic, guys.
Great.
That's great. Yeah, chorus is
Tony,
beautiful.
Is that a third verse in there?
It is a third verse. Yeah, before the last chorus.
That's the only thing, you know.
It's a little long. It needs to be edited down.
That's where it could go. But it's
good,
very
right?
Exciting. Great story.
I was so, like, I seriously was freaking out. Like, I was like, okay, right, Tony? And I'm like, I don't know what's going to happen. And then it just came. It's so weird. The process is so weird.
Instant.com.
Which one, Tony? This one?
This.
Oh, six of the ones.
Yeah, these are the
six of the ones.
Good patchouli.
Where we going?
We're going to Miami. Ooh, Krispy Kreme.
Thank you so much. Really glad I'm here. I gotta write the hits, Pete. I can't be finding autographs.
You gotta get that shit together.
Yeah, hit it.
Number one record being made in that motherfucker right now.
Sound like every fucking thing else that I ever heard.
Hey, but you know what, dude?
What?
We got a good idea here, because we got communication, and all of these things I'm finding about it is really good. Transmission, information, broadcasting. I have lots of good words we could use.
Do that booty pop thing. I love rock and roll, but it ain't the same. Right?
Yeah. It's good. Really good.
Sorry, I can't see it.
It's really like a classic song, you know? I'm telling you, that other melody's the one.
Which one? You got You keep that. That's the one you love.
I love it.
All right, so I'm gonna work with that tomorrow.
Because it reminds me of my view.
I like that though.
I know, and I love it.
Well, where did you come up with that?
Words? I didn't do it yet.
The chemistry between us is a huge part of it. You know, you can't just go and take your clothes off for anyone and expect that it's gonna be a good time. You know, it's it's basically what it is as well, because you have to strip down all of your insecurities. You have to just let yourself be free. And there's a lot of people that I work with that I could kind of get to that point, and then there's people that I just couldn't quite get there. And that's one thing when I work with No Doubt and the guys, it's like family. And there's even with them, there's times where I feel insecure.
I feel like it was a really, really huge, like, effort for me to come here right now, because right now what I could be doing is hanging out with my husband and, like, there's millions of things I could be doing, but I mean, I could kind of be having a little bit of a chill moment before a really huge tour and like a fashion show and everything's coming up. But I was like, you know what? I'm gonna come try to write a song.
It's great.
You know the words? You'll recognize everything from it, because it's all the Orange County stuff. This about this
backyard.
The
Put the bells in.
From the west side in Anaheim, a small world after all. Hanging at the hotel, selling makeup at the mall. Making out to Purple Rain just like everybody else. Find me un beso, no stop, I'm trying to save. So, in an ordinary common girl way, back in the 714 days. Trying to figure out what I'm gonna be. Hanging in the garage, me and Indy. A lot of things have changed, but I'm only the same.
How did that song inspire?
fired. How did you write that one? That's it.
That was Pharrell. Pharrell said, I know what you gotta do, and he had this like idea for a beat. I got up, I knew I had to write the lyrics to that song Breaking Up. And I just started listening to it at our workout. Like, I listened to it all morning, and I just wrote the words. And then I went in and sang it, and I had no perspective. And then anyways, we played it tonight for DJ Clue, which was rad. It was amazing. And everything sounded ridiculous. It was like, it sounded like a, I don't know. I just want to hear this.
That makes us wind up. To let the beat get under your skin, you got to open up and let it all in.
What do you think on that song?
That song?
On Luxurious.
No, that's perfect.
It's perfect how it is.
Yeah,
get that on film for Jimmy. He said it's perfect.
It's perfect. Leave it alone, Jimmy. I like this shit.
Can you hear me now? I got a signal. Hear me now. Slow it down. You can talk to me clearly now. 1 minute is all good when you're waking up. And next thing you know it's over. You're breaking up.
Oh, hi. One take.
What y'all think? Do I need anything?
I'd love, like, love it. It sounds so good. Crazy. It sounds like it was always there. It's so weird.
5 minutes.
Huh?
You did it in, like, 2 minutes.
I cannot believe how quick you did that. That's my brother. He's been following me for, like, 2 months.
Quarantine.
That's my little brother right there. He's filming.
Hi.
Hi. How are you? That's my brother.
What's up, man? Ryan, how are you? Good to see you.
That's my brother.
Hi.
How are you? Billy me. That's my little brother.
Hey, man, how's everything going?
That's my little brother. So.
Thanks. Ty.
Yeah.
Hi, Marlon. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
You don't mind my brother filming that?
Oh, no.
Why don't you take the stairs, Tom?
Okay, see ya.
That's it. Cut. I said.
Is this your reality show or something?
It's not. No, not really. Cause I started it because I'm doing a fashion show, so I was gonna film the making of that. But then it was really boring. So what was more interesting is how many things I'm doing. So
Now it's more about this album coming out of nowhere.
All of a sudden, I'm doing a record for no reason.
That's what I was like.
I had like 7 leftover songs, and then I was gonna put out like an EP or something with a DVD, and Pharrell's all, no, you have to come write some more songs. Don't just put them out. So next thing I know, I'm freaking flying over to Miami, like haven't seen my husband in, well, like 2 weeks or something, and then wrote 4 songs in 10 days.
Damn.
So it's been wild, and then he said to me when we wrote this, he goes, I'm going to leave some room for a rapper. I was like, I don't know if I really want to have a rapper. Because it's just so, I don't know. I was like, I didn't know. And he's like, well, the only guy was you. The only guy that I would let you do it with is you. And then we listened to all your songs, and then here we are.
Now here you are.
Here we are going,
that's
whoa.
Crazy.
I'm not trying to make a hip-hop record. That's the problem. I want to make a pop record that has tinges of hip-hop and dance, just want dance stuff, you know, you could dance to.
You don't understand. You doing it is going straight pop.
All those records you made were club pop.
Like.
What, the ones we made this time?
Mm-hmm. All of them going pop. Every last one of them. Oh, shit.
Yeah, do that again. Cheers to new music. to new music. That's what it has to be to, right?
Yep. And congratulations with having three songs in 2 weeks.
I came here to freaking take advantage of being able to write some more songs for Pharrell because he invited me. It was a challenge, but we conquered with four songs that are ridiculous. On top of it, I got to train 10 days straight, feeling like my body's starting to come back together, trying to get ripped from my husband, and I'm gonna go sit on the plane for 5 hours right now. Take home a little record called Candyland.
You want to know what it is right now? I just went in the studio and I just wrote with Pharrell, and it was a really incredible experience, but I really dipped into like another whole world of like following the leader in a way. Like, it's definitely his world, it's his thing. I kind of really pushed myself to go do that, and one of the songs was totally worth it. Orange County Girl for me was like, I feel like I always needed to have that song in my life, so I'm really happy about it. But I am scared about the next, if I do this other record, if it's gonna be, if I'm rushing it, if it's being greedy and trying to do another record really quick, or if I'm doing it for the right reason, why am I doing it? I do think of those things. I've never done things because I always want to do things for the right reason, you know, because I have a lot of Catholic guilt, and so I would never be able to do something unless I felt like it was for the right reasons and it was true to my heart, and I just can't live with myself, you know, that kind of stuff. So I did sit around when I was making that music this last couple of weeks and think, is this really what I'm supposed to be doing right now? You know? So yeah, I do worry about those things.
What's the matter? Stupid assholes out there.
What happened to this guy ever?
And what's he doing?
He's a rapparazzi, as we like to call them.
I don't really feel, I mean, they're gonna follow us to airport anyways, but.
How much does this happen, these paparazzi?
Most days. It's okay, it's not a big deal. It's just when they shock you. He's trying to take a picture right now from across there. See this guy? In that
is
car.
That the same guy that always is,
yeah,
out there?
Yeah, he's always here every day. I don't know who he is. I should just start hanging out with him. I would put him on salary to not take my picture.
I said, dude, come on, just a little respect for privacy. I mean,
right, standing in the middle of the street outside the house.
He's like, that? Fuck that, dude, I gotta make a living. I said, make a living like
doing something else.
Yeah, something that's decent.
Yeah, McDonald's is always hiring.
<That's> Here he comes. They're all here now. 1, 2, 3.
Hey Gwen, the cops are getting rid of them for you real quick. Do you want to hang on for a sec?
Okay,
don't
yeah.
Worry, we're not going to go anywhere for a little while.
Was that real? Right now?
Huh?
Was that real?
Yeah. Class A jerk off.
That's how he makes his living. Being a fucking leech.
Who are we following?
Ready?
Lisa.
Let's take a quick picture.
Hey Gwen. It's appreciated.
Over here, Gwen. Over here, Gwen.
All right, we rolling?
There you go, guys.
Hey, thanks a lot, Gwen.
You get one shot without the glasses, and then we'll leave you alone.
Nope.
That was honest.
Guys, we'll sign one article. Then looks alone. One article. Then looks alone. That's fine. You're done. Thank you.
Thank you.
Don't ever come walk up behind me.
Thank you very much.
Wait, can I get a picture, please?
No picture, sir. One autograph and we gotta go. Thank you.
Reggie.
We're gonna get a picture right here.
Just one picture.
No pictures, guys. Thank you.
Wow. It's like we're a parade or something.
Hey, no cameras. No cameras.
Hey, guys.
He said nothing about
how are you?
Great. How are you?
Listen to some music?
I'm gonna be in a sec.
Hey, thanks. How are you?
Okay.
I'm good.
I'm in love with him.
So today we wanted to come up and try to like decide what we're doing. Like, are we putting a record out this year? Are we, how many songs away am I? What does it mean if I, you know, I know that Pharrell has some
like he's so excited about trying to come back through underground hip, like through urban radio, and then cross over with one of the songs. He had like other. That's why he's gonna be here. Plus, he wants to play the songs. He's very excited.
Cool is out, right? Right now, the album is doing great. It does between 50,000 and 60,000 every week, right? It's you've done 3 million downloads on this album, which is extraordinary. I want to see what Kool does. If Kool takes the album in like the first three cities where it's being played and puts it in the top three, and we know that Kool's gonna be the song that's gonna do that thing, the count between that and Holla Back, then you could hold till February.
But if I have enough songs to put out a record, why wouldn't I just put a record out and fulfill my deal? And like, I mean, like, what's better for me to do?
Because you want to be with me forever. You don't want to fulfill your deal.
No, I'm just trying to look out.
I'm just saying. I don't know. This
I'm
is.
Don't
didn't you read your contract?
I said what
term
why
forever?
Me?
I mean, this is what has to happen. Is I need to leave today and know what I'm doing so I can do a photo shoot, do the artwork for the record.
I think you need to do all that no matter what.
I'm doing it. I already have people doing it. I just did 10 like straight days, every single day in the studio, four songs. I worked out every day. You know what I mean? It was like I was like in a tunnel. They sound weird. I mean, they're weird. They're pushing it this way a little bit. It's definitely more like hardcore club. It's less poppy.
Hi,
Jim.
Hi,
I'm
Ian. Like,
what's up,
nice to meet
you. Yo, just get ready, man. You have to be ready for this.
That
will
be really, really amazing.
There's a lot of them because
it's
kind of
an anthem.
Run it up!
Run it up! Run it up! Come on.
Songs and then all the R&B songs on the record.
More
you're gonna
me.
Mix them.
Sorry.
Two
discs.
Nope. One disc. No more than
number one.
One disc, no more than 12 records. Six and six.
Right now they say, oh, you know, you sold this many records, you're on the radio, this and that, but it doesn't really feel real. So I'd love to go and see who those people are that went out and bought the record and see them singing it like back to me. Kind of like there is no other feeling. Duh, hello, I'm hot. That's all I'm gonna say about it. What if I start doing this one?
and reel it in.
They're all. They get one of those things and they take me off the stage. They hook me off the stage.
No, you didn't.
I'll be on the side, like.
No, you didn't. Boo, Apollo, out of there. Take her off.
Thank you.
Who's that for then?
All of them.
Oh, for all the little lambs?
Do you want an autograph? Who wants an autograph? Could you? Okay.
Everybody's name.
Look at me.
What's her name? What's your name? How do you spell?
V-R-E-S-H-A-E.
So should I wear the sunglasses?
Let me see.
Thank you.
Yeah, have fun now. Enjoy yourself.
Are we in?
Talk to you. The first question we're gonna ask you is like, when people from the hip hop culture see you, what's the first thing they say to you? You know what I mean? And then we're gonna go to a video, and then after the video, we're gonna talk to you about Hell No or No Doubt. Like, we're gonna put you in a predicament. You say Hell No, you say No Doubt. And then we tease that we're gonna, you know, go to your new joint.
Record is quick as
Did you see him singing how rad
that
was?
Awesome.
I had to videotape him. They were so awesome.
Yes, sir.
Everybody was so sweet, and it was rad. And he'll show you the footage of it was all girls in the audience. Not all girls. It was guys, too. And all of a sudden, when I come out, and they play the video, and everybody was singing. Like, it was so loud. I went and ran back and got the camera to film them because I couldn't believe it was so awesome. It's the same for me when I hear music that I really am inspired by. It's very powerful and it can transcend, you know, I've said it 100 times, but it can transcend language and cultural barriers, and I've seen that on this record, you know. I'm gonna come off as a complete idiot because I was nervous, and it was one of those audiences and you can't hear, and the first question, the girl's all la la la, and her top comes off and she's just like, oh my god!
You see what happened when Glenn comes out here? A lot of stuff goes on.
Like,
crazy.
I got
behind the
scenes good.
It's going to be an historic show right about now.
We're going to keep the moving up.
We're going to do a bunch of first questions since this is your first time coming to the park.
Well, my mom,
the first time you ever performed in front of a live audience.
That would be 1987 in high school.
What song did you do?
I did a track called On the Radio by this band called The Selector, which is a ska group that I love.
Alright.
This purse doesn't really go with this outfit. Should I go change it? Oh my god, so wet.
Okay, so what I'm looking for is like a wall glasses. They're cute. Look at the little cherubs. Oh, look at those little, like 1920s ones. They're kind of cute. They're not right, but they're cute. Finally, I'm doing this. I've been wanting to do this for so long. It was fun.
So I guess there's a fair amount of people outside now.
How many people? Where are they?
I didn't go out by our car. Out back.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They're perfect for our house.
That's good.
Just perfect. I think this is going to be the one.
Okay.
I have a feeling. So cool looking. Who's out there? Some of my friends are out there?
We have like, I see three. Their screen's just coming out. Very excited.
It's very exciting.
Let Pete go up in the car first.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Thanks very much, and I'll see you on like Monday or Tuesday. Okay, I appreciate it.
Okay.
Thank you.
We'll come out in a second. Okay. There's a bunch of guys following us. Either if we go there, they'll follow us.
Oh,
it's better to be in the back, I think.
Fine.
Doesn't matter. We're going home now anyway.
You look cute anyway.
Thank you.
Glenn, over here? Good stuff.
Water comes. We gotta quick and get their car so they can come home with us. We're gonna have them over for lunch.
Look at me, come out of nowhere.
Bye, thank you.
Thank you.
All righty.
Thank you.
Bye, you guys.
Next album coming out?
I don't know.
No?
I'm working on it right now.
You're working on it right now? Anything for the fans?
I honestly would not go anywhere in Los Angeles by myself ever again while I'm famous. When it all crashes down and they take the fame and the celebrity away from me, and I, from dust to dust, then I will start going back to Savon's by myself. But till then, I will be with Pete. Yeah.
I'm happy to know that we're not going to Savon.
if I make music and it's good, it makes me feel happy to be alive, basically. It's the fuel of my fire. It's everything for me. It's everything for me. Everything else about me comes from the music.
See you tomorrow.
Okay.